It has been shown that having a student leader in the classroom helps students succeed. At Valencia College in 2007, 177 sections or classes had supplemental learning leaders. In 2010, 320 sections had supplemental learning leaders. This shows that the program has experienced a tremendous growth. Use the given data to find an equation of the line that predicts the future growth of the program. First of all, what I can point out here is that we have 2007 and 177 student leaders, and again in 2010 we had 320 student leaders. Taking this out of the word problem, we can write two points with an x value and a y value that could help us writing an equation of the line that would predict a scenario. Okay, so when we are given two points, we can use the slope formula, which was m equals y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1 to find the slope first. So let's label our points x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now we can plug these points into the formula, which gives us 320 minus 177 over 2010 minus 2007. Simplifying the numerator leaves us with 143, and simplifying the denominator leaves us with 3. This is not an even division. Let me point this out so we get an approximation. And usually I would leave it as a fraction, but the author of this book seems to have rounded the slope. So we have to do the same thing that we will get the same answer as in the back of the book. So this would give me 48 if I would round it. I believe it's 47.666, something like that. So 48. Now, knowing the slope and picking either one of these two points, we can use the point slope form of an equation to write our equation, which is y minus y1 equals m x minus x1. So plugging in our values, we have 177 equals 48 and x minus 2007. Using distributive property to eliminate the parentheses, we have y minus 177 equals 48x minus 96,336. Last step, add 177 to both sides. And you will get y equals 48x minus 96,159. So we found the equation of the line that could represent this scenario to calculate any future predictions.